Hello my dear students, in this lecture we are going to see multiplate clutch. In previous lecture we have seen single plate clutch. With single plate clutch we have to correlate this multiplate clutch. Now here the schematic of multiplate clutch is shown. Here it is an engine arrangement where it is a cylinder of engine, it is a piston of engine, piston rod, connecting rod and crankshaft, right? Therefore, this total assembly is considered as engine, and this engine you are going to see in IC engine topic, that is thermodynamics topic. And here it is a crankshaft. This is a crankshaft which is rotating with some angular velocity omega, right? Now this crankshaft is connected to the flywheel where energy is stored, and this flywheel will supply energy whenever required for other parts of machine element. Therefore, it is a flywheel. The purpose of flywheel is to store the excess energy produced by the engine and supply this whenever required. Now, on flywheel, these are the friction plates. These are the clutch plates, right? Here, these are the clutch plates connected to the flywheel. Now, here, engine is a driver. Therefore, these plates which are connected to the flywheel or driver, we can say plates on driver. Clutch plates on driver, right? The plates which I have given here hatching, the plates for which hatching is provided, these plates are called plates on driver. Now for these plates on driver, the other plates are connected which are connected to the remaining parts of the machine element, means these plates are mounted on the clutch shaft. This is the clutch shaft, right? Here I can say this is a clutch shaft. And other plates for which I have not provided hatching, these plates are mounted on the clutch shaft. And rest other devices, gearbox and wheels, are connected to this clutch shaft. Means power is transmitted from the clutch shaft to the other machine elements. Therefore, these plates are called plates on driven. Right? These plates are called plates on driven. Plates on driven or follower, we can say driven as follower, or plates on clutch shaft, we can say plates on clutch shaft also. Clutch shaft also, right? Now here it is a pressure plate, same like single plate clutch. Here it is a pressure plate, same like single plate clutch. Now on this pressure plate, with the help of a spring, the force is exerted, right? And this force is termed as normal reaction or load. Normal load W is exerted on the friction plates or on the clutch plates, right? Now here between two collars there is a clutch wire, right? These are the collars, right? And between these two collars there is a clutch wire. This is a clutch wire. Now there is no clutch pedal, because generally this multiplate clutch is used in two-wheelers. Therefore, in two-wheelers, the clutch is in your hand. Therefore, we need clutch wire. But single plate clutch is used in four-wheelers, heavy vehicles. Therefore, in single plate clutch, there is a clutch pedal, because we are operating clutch with the help of your leg for four-wheelers or heavy vehicles. But for two-wheelers, you are operating clutch with the help of your hands. Therefore, here it is a clutch wire. Right. This is a schematic arrangement of multiplate clutch. Now my dear students, look here. Now this arrangement over here is a clutch arrangement, that is plates on driver and plates on follower are called clutch plates, right? Therefore here the schematic arrangement of clutch plate is here. This is a total view, this is a clutch arrangement or clutch view, right? That is plates on driver and plates on follower, or clutch plates on driven, or also called plates on clutch shaft. This is the main clutch, right? Now look here. Now here in this case, let us say N1 is plates on driver and N2 is plates on driven or follower. Now with the help of this N1, that is plates on driver, and N2 plates on follower, we are going to derive the formula. Now here I am not going to derive detailed formula. Only we are using the results of single plate clutch, and these results we are projecting for multiplate clutch. Now here the plates with hatching are plates on driver and plates without hatching are plates on follower. Let us say N1 is plates on driver and N2 is plates on follower. Now look at here, there is a direct physical contact between them, and with the help of friction between them, they are transmitting the power. Now here there is a friction lining, 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 right? Now here I have considered total 5 plates, that is total plates can we say is equal to N1 plus N2. But my dear students, power is transmitted because of the friction between the plates. Power is always transmitted, or torque is transmitted, because of the friction between the plates. Now here look at how many surfaces having friction. Look here, for in how many surfaces there is a friction. See, in this contacting surface there is a friction. Here one frictional surface in contact, here another frictional surface in contact, here another frictional surface in contact, third, and here another frictional surface in contact, fourth. Means for total 5 plates there are total 4 surfaces in contact which are responsible for power transmission. Means friction is because of these 4 contacting surfaces, right? Therefore total plates or total surfaces for power transmission, we can say total surfaces for power transmission is equal to N1 plus N2 minus 1. This we can say, means we have to consider the surfaces which are responsible for power transmission. Therefore here total surfaces for power transmission is equal to N is equal to N1 plus N2 minus 1. This is very important. Now how many plates are responsible for power transmission? Then we can say N plates, that is N1 plus N2 minus 1. Now already in previous lecture we have derived formulas for single plate clutch, that is as per uniform pressure theory. First we have considered uniform pressure theory. Now as per this pressure theory, that is pressure is constant, torque transmitted is equal to 2/3 mu w r o cube minus r I cube divided by r o square minus r I square. This formula we have derived, where t is a torque transmitted, right? Then mu is coefficient of friction, w is normal load, the w is normal load, r o is outside radius, and r I is inside radius. This is the torque transmitted by single plate clutch. It is the formula for single plate clutch as per uniform pressure theory. Now but for multi plate clutch, total N plates are in contact, that is N is equal to number of plates on driver plus number of plates on driver minus 1. This much surfaces are there available for power transmission. Therefore torque will become N times torque of single plate clutch. Torque of single plate clutch for multi plate clutch, torque will be N times torque of single plate clutch. Therefore torque transmitted is equal to N into 2/3 mu w r o cube minus r I cube divided by r o square minus r I square. This is the torque transmitted by multi plate clutch as per uniform pressure theory. This is very important, and uniform pressure theory is used for new clutches. These all concepts I have already explained in single plate clutch topic, right? Now second, as per uniform wear theory, that is product of pressure and radius is constant, right? Now torque transmitted for single plate clutch is mu 1/2. The formula is 1/2 mu w r o plus r I. Now this is for single plate clutch. But for multi plate clutch, total N plates are in contact, or total N surfaces, friction surfaces are transmitting power. Therefore torque transmitted is equal to N times, that is single plate clutch, that is 1/2 mu w r o plus r I. This is torque transmitted by multi plate clutch as per uniform wear theory. And this uniform wear theory is used for old clutches, right? And generally single plate clutch are used in heavy vehicles such as trucks, buses, and multi plate clutches are used in light vehicles such as two wheelers. Thank you, dear students. In next lecture, we will see conical clutch.